Hey everyone, welcome back to Heroes Workshop. This is Stealth, and I'm here to review the Ender 3 Max Neo 3D printer. Creality was kind enough to send me this printer and check it out. Even though on this channel I don't really do 3D printed stuff, I mostly do EVA foam cosplay projects, I am versed and I do have experience with 3D printers. I have made 3D printed props and helmets and, you know, finished them up for private commissions and such. So I have a little bit of knowledge on 3D printers and the Cura software to slice the files to get the G codes and all that. So we're gonna see how this printer prints out of the box and see how much better it is than the original Ender 3 Max. Assembly was pretty straightforward. Didn't take much, just a few screws and a few connectors to plug in. This was kind of annoying, setting up this display, the mount for it. I like that this printer has a little storage compartment. I do like the position of the filament spool versus having it over top. Also remember to set your voltage properly. All right, so as with most 3D printers, once you have it assembled, you gotta do the bed leveling. And then fine tune the dials, like the knobs on each corner with a sheet of paper to get the height of the nozzle. And then did corner by corner. And then after that, I did the auto leveling feature. One of the cool features that this printer has over the original model is the CR Touch auto bed leveling sensor. So now that I had the 3D printer assembled, it was time to print something. So I loaded some of the PLA filament that came with the printer. So opened up Cura, the software that I was going to use to slice the model. I just used the available Ender 3 Max profile, since the dimensions are pretty much the same. I loaded the Benchy model. This is the most universally used model to test a printer. It's considered like the stress test because you can test overhangs and under extrusion and stringing, and then you can adjust from there and then reprint it and see if there's any improvements. So I printed with a 0.2 layer height, 10% infill. I printed at 60 millimeters per second, 205 degrees Fahrenheit for the filament temperature. And I didn't put any supports because I just wanted to see like the overhangs, how they do. And I just sliced it and then loaded it up into the USB with the SD card caddy that's supplied, and just loaded in the printer and then started printing. I did like the display that came with this printer. I like the dial to move around in the menu. It's really easy to use for beginners, and you're able to adjust prints on the fly, like temperature and Z offset and things like that. It has the most important settings that you'll need to make sure your print turns out okay. So the first attempt at printing didn't go so well. I had some layer adhesion issues on the first layer, so I corrected that with lowering the Z offset, and it seemed to correct that problem. One thing I noticed immediately about this printer is how quiet it was. I've used printers in the past and they're so noisy. When this is running, all you hear are the cooling fans. Once the print was finished, I removed it from the print bed. I didn't have any issues removing it, I guess because it's a small print, but I've seen other people say that it's been very difficult to remove prints and you have to let the bed cool down. I didn't let it cool down at all. I just removed it and it seemed to come off fine without any issues. You can see some under extrusion. I did increase the temperature to 210 and it corrected the under extrusion issues. And the overhang isn't so bad. And there's a little bit of stringing, but not too bad. All in all, it was a decent print for the first go. Instead of printing another Benchy, I printed this Wolverine action figure as a better test for the printer. I printed it at 0.16, so the detail will be a little bit better and higher quality, but I also printed it at 200 millimeters high, so I want a bigger action figure instead of the default scale. I didn't need to add supports on this either because supports come included with the model itself. With the adjustment of the Z offset and the temperature from the previous print, this print had zero issues, no under extrusion, no anything. The details are very good, considering it's 0.16, hardly any flaws in it. Only a tiny bit of stringing on the top of the ears, but hardly anything, nothing to worry about. And the joints work perfectly on the arms and the legs. It's so cool, like right off the bed, you just move the arms and legs a bit and they just start working. The joints were modeled into this print, and technology really is amazing. For the next print, I printed something actually cosplay related. I wanted to make something that I've always wanted ever since I was a kid. So I printed this. I printed a Batman cowl from the 1989 film with Michael Keaton. It's one of my favorite cowls. I printed this at 0.16 layer height because I wanted it in higher detail. The print was pretty nice for the most part, except for under the chin, nose, and eyes. That's where the supports were. With a little bit of sanding, you can just get those areas nice and smooth. To make this cowl actually wearable, you would have to clean up all the imperfections and get the cowl nice and smooth. Then you would mold it in silicone rubber and then cast in urethane rubber, similar to the methods used in the movie industry to actually make the cowl from the film. Creality Ender 3 Max Neo, great printer out of the box, has great features like these belt tensioners that as the belt wears out, you can just tighten them, get more longevity out of it. The filament runout sensor is always great to have, along with the upgraded metal extruder, upgraded from the plastic one of the original Ender Max. Once again, great printer, I highly recommend it. If you're interested in getting one, I have links in the description. Print some cool stuff and have fun. This is Stealth from Heroes Workshop. I'll see you guys soon with another video. Stealth, answer me. Stealth!